Welcome to another Bible study on the Feed My Sheep Foundation channel. On this video, we are doing a study, taking a look into what the Word says about honey. Honey is the Word. And that is the revelation we have for today. As you can see, we have the revelation window up. And as the Lord reveals, we are going to definitely talk about it on this channel and bring it to light, bring it out of darkness, because God does not want us to be ignorant. Okay, He wants us to know His Word and have revelation, wisdom, and knowledge of Him and the heavens. Okay, so the first place I'm going to go with this word is Ezekiel. Ezekiel was a prophet in the Old Testament, and Ezekiel's name, let me go here to it, because we haven't did a Bible study on Ezekiel. But Ezekiel was a priest, he was a prophet, and he ministers, okay, and he was always sent by God somewhere to speak to the children of Israel. Okay, so his name in the Hebrew, it means God strengthens, okay? God strengthens is his name, because, you know, as we went over several times on this video channel, the names that God uses, everything about God, and we know this too, is significant. Everything is strategic, is significant, is detailed, and it's purposeful. Everything is purposeful, okay? And so, names have meanings. All of the names in the Bible that he used, the great prophets and apostles that he used. So, Ezekiel, again, his name means God strengthens. So, as we get into this regarding honey, honey is the word, okay? So, Ezekiel chapter 3, I'm going to start with verse 1. He says, I'm going to start with verse. It says, moreover, he said unto me, son of man. Okay, so this is what Ezekiel is saying, that he's having a conversation with the Spirit of the Lord, okay? And the Lord is saying, hear what I say unto you, okay? Because he's getting ready. He's talking with the Lord. He says, and the Lord is talking with him. He says, moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat what thou findest, eat this roll, and go speak unto the house of Israel. Okay? Now, this roll that he's talking about, that he wants him to eat, he says, so I opened my mouth, and he caused me to eat that roll. Okay? And he said unto me, son of man, cause thy belly to eat and fill thy bowels with this roll. Okay, and eat, and it was in my mouth as honey for sweetness. And then he said unto me, son of man, go. Get up and go unto the house of Israel and speak with my words unto them. For you are sent, you are not sent to a people of that are, you know, a strange or unfamiliar of the, you know, of these words, he says, and that are not familiar with these words, but you are sent, he was sent to the house of Israel, people that are waiting to basically hear God's words. Okay, so, they're familiar with his words, they might not want to hear it. But they were, some of them, because, you know, it might come with a little judgment. But they were familiar with his words. Okay, so therefore, just going back into what, you know, keeping on the focus of, that the honey is the word. And that is what Ezekiel was referring to whenever he says he did eat the roll, and basically... we know that roll is the root word or part of the word for scroll, and we know that scroll is, you know, as in the old years prior to the day, was referred to something that you read, basically. Okay? And so he did. He read it. He read what he was told to read. And he says, and then I'm going to skip around to some of the verses. In verse 7, he says, even though, but he's going to say these words to them, but he says, but the house of Israel will not hearken unto you, for they will not hearken unto me. For all the house of Israel are impudent and hard-hearted. Okay, so this was during a time when they were, you know, they were walking in rebellion. And that's, you know, the majority of the times when the prophets were sent to the children of Israel is when, you know, and even today, whenever something's going on or some type of rebellion is happening. And so then, let me see, where else is there another one right here? Let's see. Okay, so that's it for this chapter and this book. For honey is the word, because this is where, as we can see, Ezekiel had a conversation with God, the Spirit of God. And actually, if you start over in chapter 2, it goes into, you know, just from chapter 2, verse 2, he said, the Spirit entered into me when he spoke unto me and set me upon my feet, that I heard him and he spake unto me. So if you want to go back and just recap and see where, you know, he did start speaking to God and God began to say these things to him. And then it was said that verse 3, where he says, and then I did eat. He did eat the word, and it was in his mouth, and it, as honey for sweet. It tasted, it was so sweet, it was like honey. Okay, so then another chapter and another book I'm led over to in reference to honey being the word is Revelation chapter 10. Revelation chapter 10. And that is another. Okay, Revelation chapter 10. Okay? And then with the emphasis. I'm going to read the whole chapter, actually. Chapter 10, verse 1 in Revelations. I saw another mighty angel come down from heaven, clothed with a cloud, and a rainbow was upon his head, and his face was as it were the sun, and his feet was pillars of fire. So this is John. The book of Revelation is John in the spirit. He's having visions and dreams because he's in the spirit and he's seeing things. God is revealing things to him. Okay, and this is what's happening right here. He says in verse 2, and he had in his hand a little book open. Okay, so first, you know, recollect what he says in verse 1. He saw a mighty angel come down from heaven. Okay. A mighty angel come down from heaven. He had in his hand a little book open, and he set his right foot upon the sea, and he and his left foot on the earth. Can you imagine that? Oh, Jesus, that's powerful. An angel, he set his foot, one of his foot on the sea, and another foot on the earth. And then cried with a loud voice, as when a lion roars, and when he had cries. And seven thunders uttered their voices. His voice was so powerful. And when the seven thunders had uttered their voices, I was about to write. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, seal up those things which the seven thunders uttered, and write them not. Seal them up, and write them not. And the angel which I saw stand upon the sea and upon the earth lifted up his hand to heaven. Okay? and swear by him that lives forever and ever, who created heaven and the things that are in the earth and the things that are in the heaven and the sea and the things that are, you know, and everything. And there should be no time, no longer, no more delay. Okay? And then he goes on to say, okay, and then he goes on. Wait a minute here. What in the world? Okay. This computer started to act up again. But okay, here we go. So, we're in Revelation chapter 10. Where was I at? Okay, the seven thunders roared, and the angel saw, and he swore behind him. Okay, so it says, and the angel which I saw stand up on the sea and open the earth lifted up his hand to heaven. Okay, so the angel lifted up their hands to him and swear by him that lives forever and ever, who created heaven and the things that are in heaven and in the earth and the things that are, you know, everywhere that were ever created. He says, but in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished, as he had declared to his servants the prophets. And the voice which I heard from heaven spake unto me again and said, go and take the little book which is open in the hand of the angel which stands upon the sea and upon the earth. Okay, now again, you know, this is a vision. And everything about this vision is supernatural. Okay? And he says, go and take the little book which is open in the hand of the angel which stands upon the sea and the earth. And I went into, when he went to the angel, he said unto him, give me the little book. And he said unto me, take it, eat it up, and it shall make thy belly bitter, but it shall be in thy mouth sweet as honey. Honey is the word. Hallelujah. So then in verse 10, and he says, and I took the little book out of the angel's hand and ate it up, and it was in my mouth sweet as honey. And as soon as I had eaten it, my belly was bitter. And the angel said to me, now you must prophesy again before many peoples and nations and tongues and kings. Okay? So, sweet Jesus, hallelujah. Honey is the holy word of God. Oh, my God, my God, my God. Okay, so that was the vision that John had in reference to the word of God and God telling him to eat the word. Eat the word. Basically, read the word, get it in your mouth, understand the word, get it in your mind, get it down inside you. It's basically what God is saying with that. And then after he was fed the word, he told him that he must go and prophesy to many peoples and nations and tongues and kings. Prophesy and speak the word. Okay? And I'm not going to go into the actual revelation of this chapter, but we want to just make sure we stay focused on the honey is word, because that's what we want to get. That's what we're going to draw our Bible study and our attention to mainly, and how that in the word, the Lord God Almighty, he refers to his word as honey. Honey, 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 honey. Woo, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. So God bless you. And I will see you as we continue to go forward on the Feed My Sheep Foundation Bible Study Video Channel. In Jesus Christ's mighty, mighty, powerful name. Amen.